Actually, I'm gonna start at John chapter 13, starting at verse 31. We're just gonna do a little reading.
Amen. That's good. Amen.
So praise God. So it's St. John chapter 13, starting at verse 31. And it reads, "So when he had gone out, Jesus said, 'Now the Son of Man is glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and glorify him immediately. Little children, I say, I shall be with you a little while longer. You will seek me, and as I said to the Jews, where I am going, you cannot come. So now I say to you, a new commandment I give to you, that you love one another as I have loved you, that you also love one another. By this, all will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another.' Simon Peter said to him, 'Lord, where are you going?' And Jesus answered him, 'Where I am going, you cannot follow me now, but you shall follow me afterward.' Peter said to him, 'Lord, why can I not follow you now? I will lay down my life for your sake.' And Jesus answered him, 'Will you lay down your life for my sake? Most assuredly, I say to you, the rooster shall not crow till you have denied me three times.'"
Amen.
Amen. And then he goes on to say, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, you know, and the way you know." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, and how can we know the way?" And Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you had known me, you would have known my Father also. And from now on, you know him and have seen him." Praise God.
Amen.
When I think about the scripture, says, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me." And it talks about how Jesus was going to be leaving them. And they were sorrowful. You know, they had the Savior there with them. They had seen many wonderful and marvelous things.
Yeah.
You know, that was right there before their eyes. And so he began to tell them that I am going to be going. So their heart began to become troublesome, sorrowsome.
Yeah.
And wanted to know where he was going. And he told them, you know, "Let not your heart be troubled."
Yeah.
You know, "You believe in me, believe also in God. And I'm going to prepare a place for you." So sometimes as Christian people, we can go through situations where if we don't know where our trust is,
yeah,
who our faith is in, it can cause us to faint. It can cause us to faint in our heart and to lose hope. But Jesus said, "I'm going to prepare a place for you, that where I'm going, you can also be." And he said, "In my Father's house are many mansions."
Many.
Many rooms filled with these present and pleasant riches. You know, and that's where I'm going, so you can go there also. And then we know, I believe it's in Ephesians, he said, he has blessed us with all spiritual things hidden in Christ Jesus. But
yeah,
we don't find them until we seek first Jesus, which right, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Come on.
So as we seek first him, then we find all of these wonderful riches.
Amen.
The life. You know, many times we try to seek for joy, we try to seek for peace, we try to seek for love and comfort, and we try to seek it first forth in different things. But he says, seek first the kingdom of heaven and all its righteousness, and then all of these things shall be added.
Hallelujah, glory to God, hallelujah.
So even though their heart was troubled and they might have felt like, well, what do we do now? He said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life to all that you're looking for. And my Father's house are many mansions.
Amen.
And I'm
going
to prepare a place for you. So where I go, you can
glory
be also."
Hallelujah.
So now as we accept Jesus Christ, we're covered in the blood. Now we can enter in into this mansion that God has prepared
and come on,
rich.
Hallelujah, glory to God.
So your heart don't have to be troubled.
Don't have to be troubled.
Don't have to be sorrowful.
Come on,
don't
come
have
on. Come on, that's right, that's
because
right.
He is the comforter. Over in Isaiah, I believe, chapter 9 and 5, it said he is the comforter. He is the Prince of Peace.
Yeah.
He is all of that.
Woo.
Your heart don't have to be troubled. troubled, you don't have to faint, you don't have to lose heart. But how do you find this comfort, this joy, and this peace? All of these spiritual blessings, they're hidden in Christ Jesus. So he is the way, the truth, and the life. And as you find him, you find the truth, you find the life, and you find the way.
Amen.
For God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten son, that whoever should believe in him should not perish in this discomfort, should not perish in losing hope.
Come
should
on.
Not
perish. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen.
To let your heart not be troubled. But
amen.
If you believe in God, believe also in Jesus Christ. Some people, they only believe in God. But he said, you believe in God, believe also in me.
Amen.
So praise God. So it's in him. You know, we have other different religions where, you know, it's they believe in God, but they don't necessarily believe in Jesus Christ.
Right,
and
right.
They still have all of these things that go forth, these trials and tribulations that they can't overcome.
Right.
But he said, you believe in God, believe also in me.
Amen.
I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life.
Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen.